This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. The culture of the United States of America is primarily Western, but is influenced by African, Native American, Asian, Polynesian, and Latin American cultures. It also has its own social and cultural characteristics, such as dialect, music, arts, social habits, cuisine, and folklore. The United States of America is an ethnically and racially diverse country as a result of large-scale migration from many countries throughout its history. Its chief early European influences came from English settlers of colonial America during British rule due to colonial ties with Britain that spread the English language, British culture, legal system and other cultural inheritances, had a formative influence. Other important influences came from other parts of Europe, especially Germany. Original elements also play a strong role, such as Jeffersonian democracy. Thomas Jefferson's Notes on the State of Virginia was perhaps the first influential domestic cultural critique by an American and was written in reaction to the views of some influential Europeans that America's native flora, fauna, including humans, were degenerate. American culture includes both conservative and liberal elements, scientific and religious competitiveness, political structures, risk-taking and free expression, materialist and moral elements despite certain consistent ideological principles e.g. individualism, egalitarianism, and faith in freedom and democracy. American culture has a variety of expressions due to its geographical scale and demographic diversity. The flexibility of U.S. culture and its highly symbolic nature leads some researchers to categorize American culture as a mythic identity. Others see it as American exceptionalism. It also includes elements that evolved from indigenous Americans and other ethnic cultures, most prominently the culture of African Americans, cultures from Latin America, and Asian American cultures. Many American cultural elements, especially from popular culture, have spread across the globe through modern mass media. The United States has traditionally been thought of as a melting pot. However, beginning in the 1960s and continuing on in the present day, the country trends towards cultural diversity, pluralism, and the image of a salad bowl instead. Due to the extent of American culture, there are many integrated but unique social subcultures within the United States. The cultural affiliations an individual in the United States may have commonly depend on social class, political orientation, and a multitude of demographic characteristics such as religious background, occupation, and ethnic group membership. Contents 1. Regional variations 11. Fisher's theory 12. Woodard's theory 2. Language 21. Native language statistics for the United States 3. Literature 4. Fine arts 41. Architecture 42. Theater 43. Dance 44. Music 45. Cinema 46. Broadcasting 5. Science and technology 6. Education 7. Religion 71. Statistics 8. Folklore 9. National holidays 10. Fashion and dress 11. Names 12. Sports 121. Sports and community culture 13. Cuisine 14. Family structure 141. Youth dependence 15. Housing 151. Automobiles and commuting 16. Social class and work 17. Race and ancestry 18. Death and funerals 19. Sociological issues 191. Marriage and divorce 192. Race relations 193. Drugs and alcohol 20. Volunteerism 21. Military culture 22. Gun culture 23. Governmental role 24. Influence 25. See also 26. References 27. Further reading 28. External links. Regional variations. Semi-distinct cultural regions of the United States include New England, the Mid-Atlantic states, the Southern United States, the Midwestern United States, and the Western United States, an area that can be further subdivided, on the basis of the local culture, into the Pacific states and the Mountain states, the western coast of the continental United States consisting of California, Oregon, and the state of Washington is also sometimes referred to as the left coast, indicating its left-leaning political orientation and tendency towards social liberalism. Southern United States are informally called the Bible Belt due to socially conservative evangelical Protestantism, which is a significant part of the region's culture, and Christian church attendance across the denominations is generally higher there than the nation's average. This region is usually contrasted with the mainline Protestantism and Catholicism of the northeastern United States, the religiously diverse Midwest and Great Lakes, the Mormon Corridor in Utah and southern Idaho, and the relatively secular western United States. The Percentage of non-religious people is the highest in the northeastern state of Vermont at 34%, compared to the Bible Belt state of Alabama, where it is 6%. Strong cultural differences have a long history in the U.S., with the Southern slave society in the antebellum period serving as a prime example. Not only social, but also economic tensions between the northern and southern states were so severe that they eventually caused the South to declare itself an independent nation, the Confederate States of America, thus initiating the American Civil War. Fisher's theory. David Hackett Fisher theorizes that the United States is made up today of four distinct regional cultures. The book's focus is on the folkways of four groups of settlers from the British Isles that emigrated from distinct regions of Britain and Ireland to the British American colonies during the 17th and 18th centuries. Fisher's thesis is that the culture and folkways of each of these groups persisted, albeit with some modification over time, providing the basis for the four modern regional cultures of the United States. According to Fisher, the foundation of American culture was formed from four mass migrations from four different regions of the British Isles by four distinct socio-religious groups. New England's earliest settlement period occurred between 1629 and 1640, when Puritans, mostly from East Anglia in England, settled there, forming the New England regional culture. The next mass migration was of Southern English Cavaliers and their working-class English domestic servants to the Chesapeake Bay region between 1640 and 1675. This facilitated the development of the Southern American culture. Then between 1675 and 1725, thousands of English and Welsh Quakers, led by William Penn, settled in the Delaware Valley, followed by large numbers of German Lutherans. This settlement resulted in the formation of what is today considered the general American culture, although, according to Fisher, it is really just a regional American culture, even if it does today encompass most of the U.S. from the mid-Atlantic states to the Pacific coast. Finally, Scotch-Irish, English and Scottish settlers from the borderlands of Britain and Ireland migrated to Appalachia between 1717 and 1775. They formed the regional culture of the Upland South, which has since spread west to such areas as West Texas and parts of the U.S. Southwest. Fisher suggests that the U.S. today is not a country with one general American culture and three or more regional subcultures. He asserts that the country is composed of just regional cultures, and that understanding that helps one to understand many things about modern American life. Fisher also makes the point that the development of these regional cultures derived not only from where exactly the settlers first came, but when they came. Fisher asserts that during different periods of time, a population of people will have very distinct beliefs, fears, hopes, and prejudices, and that various groups of settlers brought these feelings to the New World, where they more or less froze in time in America, even if they eventually changed in their place of origin. Woodard's theory. Continuing the work of Fisher, Colin Woodard, in his book American Nations, claims an existence of 11 rival regional cultures in North America, based on the cultural characteristics of the original settlers of these regions. These regions are, Yankeedom, New Netherland, the Midlands, Tidewater, Greater Appalachia, the Deep South, New France, El Norte, the Left Coast, the Far West and First Nation, a region in parts of northern Canada and Alaska, and Greenland. According to Woodard, these regions cross and disregard formal state or even country borders. For example, he compares the Mexican border with the Berlin Wall, saying that El Norte in some ways resembles Germany during the Cold War, two peoples with a common culture separated by a large wall. Language. Main article, Languages of the United States. Although the United States has no official language at the federal level, 28 states have passed legislation making English the official language, and it is considered to be the de facto national language. According to the 2000 U.S. Census, more than 97% of Americans can speak English well, and for 81% it is the only language spoken at home. More than 300 languages besides English have native speakers in the United States, some of which are spoken by the indigenous peoples. About 150 living languages and others imported by immigrants. Spanish has official status in the Commonwealth of Puerto Rico and the state of New Mexico. Spanish is the primary spoken language in Puerto Rico and various smaller linguistic enclaves. According to the 2000 census, there are nearly 30 million native speakers of Spanish in the United States. Bilingual speakers may use both English and Spanish reasonably well, but code switch according to their dialogue partner or context. Some refer to this phenomenon as Spanglish. Indigenous languages of the United States include the Native American languages, which are spoken on the country's numerous Indian reservations, and Native American cultural events such as pow-wows, Hawaiian, which has official official status in the state of Hawaii, Chamorro, which has official status in the Commonwealths of Guam and the Northern Mariana Islands, Carolinian, which has official status in the Commonwealth of the Northern Mariana Islands, and Samoan, which has official status in the Commonwealth of American Samoa. American Sign Language, used mainly by the deaf, is also native to the country. The national dialect is known as American English, which itself consists of numerous regional dialects but has some shared unifying features that distinguish it from other national varieties of English. There are four large dialect regions in the United States: the North, the Midland, the South, and the West, and several smaller dialect regions such as those of New York City, Philadelphia, and Boston. A standard dialect called General American, analogous in some respects to the received pronunciation elsewhere in the English-speaking world, lacking the distinctive noticeable features of any particular region, is believed by some to exist as well. It is sometimes regionally associated with the vaguely defined Midwest native language statistics for the United States. The following information is an estimation, as actual statistics constantly vary according to the CIA. The following is the percentage of total population's native languages in the United States: English 821%, Spanish 107%, other Indo-European languages 38%, other Asian or Pacific Islander languages 27%, other languages 07%, literature. Main article, American literature. Mark Twain is regarded as among the greatest writers in American history. The right to freedom of expression in the American Constitution can be traced to German immigrant John Peter Zenger and his legal fight to make truthful publications in the colonies a protected legal right, ultimately paving the way for the protected rights of American authors in the 18th and early 19th centuries. American art and literature took most of its cues from Europe during its early history. America was a series of British colonies on the eastern coast of the present-day United States. Therefore, its literary tradition begins as linked to the broader tradition of English literature. However, unique American characteristics and the breadth of its production usually now cause it to be considered a separate path and tradition. America's first internationally popular writers were James Fenimore Cooper and Washington Irving. In the early 19th century, they painted an American literary landscape full of humor and adventure. These were followed by Nathaniel Hawthorne, Edgar Allan Poe, Herman Melville, Ralph Waldo Emerson, Henry Wadsworth Longfellow, and Henry David Thoreau, who established a distinctive American literary voice in the middle of the 19th century. Mark Twain, Henry James, and poet Walt Whitman were major figures in the century's second half. Emily Dickinson, virtually unknown during her lifetime, would be recognized as America's other essential poet. 11 U.S. citizens have won the Nobel Prize in Literature, including John Steinbeck, William Faulkner, Eugene O'Neill, Pearl S. Buck, T.S. Eliot, and Sinclair Lewis. Ernest Hemingway, the 1954 Nobel laureate, is often named as one of the most influential writers of the 20th century, a work seen as capturing fundamental aspects of the national experience and character, such as Herman Melville's Moby Dick 1851, Twain's The Adventures of Huckleberry Finn 1885, and F. Scott Fitzgerald's The Great Gatsby 1925, may be dubbed the Great American Novel. Popular literary genres such as the Western and hard-boiled crime fiction were developed in the United States fine arts in the late 18th and early 19th centuries. American artists primarily painted landscapes and portraits in a realistic style. A parallel development taking shape in rural America was the American craft movement, which began as a reaction to the Industrial Revolution. Developments in modern art in Europe came to America from exhibitions in New York City, such as the Armory Show in 1913. After World War II, New York emerged as a center of the art world. Painting in the United States today covers a vast range of styles. American painting includes works by Jackson Pollock, John Singer Sargent, and Norman Rockwell, among many others. Architecture. The Art Deco architectural style of the Empire State Building was typical of such buildings of the period. Main article, Architecture of the United States. Architecture in the United States is regionally diverse and has been shaped by many external forces. Not only English, U.S. architecture can therefore be said to be eclectic, something unsurprising in such a multicultural society. In the absence of a single large-scale architectural influence from indigenous peoples such as those in Mexico or Peru, generations of designers have incorporated integrated influences from around the world currently, the overriding theme of American architecture is modernity, as manifest in the skyscrapers of the 20th century. Early neoclassicism accompanied the Founding Fathers' idealization of European Enlightenment, making it the predominant architectural style for public buildings and large manors. However, in recent years, suburbanization and mass migration to the Sun Belt has allowed architecture to reflect a Mediterranean style as well. Theater. This section needs expansion. You can help by adding to it October 2012 main article. Theater of the United States. Theater of the United States is based in the Western tradition and did not take on a unique dramatic identity until the emergence of Eugene O'Neill in the early 20th century, now considered by many to be the father of American drama. O'Neill is a four-time winner of the Pulitzer Prize for Drama and the only American playwright to win the Nobel Prize for Literature after O'Neill. American drama came of age and flourished with the likes of Arthur Miller, Tennessee Williams, Lillian Hellman, William Ng, and Clifford Oditz during the first half of the 20th century. After this fertile period, American theater broke new ground, artistically, with the absurdist forms of Edward Albee in the 1960s. Social commentary has also been a preoccupation of American theater, often addressing issues not discussed in the mainstream. Writers such as Lorraine Hansberry, August Wilson, David Mamet, and Tony Kushner have all won Pulitzer Prizes for their polemical plays on American society. The United States is also the home and largest exporter of modern musical theater, producing such musical talents as Rodgers and Hammerstein, Lerner and Lowe, Cole Porter, Irving Berlin, Leonard Bernstein, George and Ira Gershwin, Kander and Ebb, and Stephen Sondheim. Broadway is one of the largest theater communities in the world and is the epicenter of American commercial theater. Dance. Main article, dance in the United States. The United States is represented by various genres of dance, from ballet to hip-hop and folk music. Frank Sinatra is awarded the Presidential Medal of Freedom by President Ronald Reagan. Main articles, music of the United States and music history of the United States. Further information, category, American singers. Further information, list of American composers. American music styles and influences such as rock and roll, jazz, rock, techno, country, hip-hop, rap, and music based on them can be heard all over the world. Music in the U.S. is diverse. It includes African American influence in the 20th century. The first half of this century is famous for jazz, introduced by African Americans in the South in the 1960s, 1970s, 1980s, and 1990s. Rock was prevalent. Cinema actor James Dean is a cultural icon of teenage disillusionment. Main article, cinema of the United States. The cinema of the United States, often generally referred to as Hollywood, has had a profound effect on cinema across the world since the early 20th century. While the Lumiere brothers are generally credited with the birth of modern cinema, it is American cinema that has emerged as the most dominant force in the industry. Its history can be separated into four main periods: the silent film era, classical Hollywood cinema, New Hollywood, and the contemporary period. Actor James Dean, who appeared in films during the classical Hollywood era until his untimely death, is widely regarded as an American cultural icon of teenage disillusionment. American independent cinema was revitalized in the late 1980s and early 1990s when another new generation of moviemakers, including Spike Lee, Steven Soderbergh, Kevin Smith, and Quentin Tarantino, made movies like, respectively, Do the Right Thing, Sex, Lies, and Videotape, Clerks, and Reservoir Dogs. In terms of directing, screenwriting, editing, and other elements, these movies were innovative and often irreverent, playing with and contradicting the conventions of Hollywood movies. Furthermore, their considerable financial successes and crossover into popular culture re-established the commercial viability of independent film. Since then, the independent film industry has become more clearly defined and more influential in American cinema. Many of the major studios have capitalized on this by developing subsidiaries to produce similar films, for example Fox Searchlight Pictures to a lesser degree in the early 21st century. Film types that were previously considered to have only a minor presence in the mainstream movie market began to arise as more potent American box office draws. These include foreign language films such as Crouching Tiger, Hidden Dragon and Hero, and documentary films such as Super Size Me, March of the Penguins, and Michael Moore's Bowling for Columbine and Fahrenheit 9/11. Broadcasting main articles, television in the United States and radio in the United States. American family watching TV, 1958. Television is a major mass media of the United States. Household ownership of television sets in the country is 967%, and the majority of households have more than one set. The peak ownership percentage of households with at least one television set occurred during the 1996-97 season, with 984% ownership as a whole. The television networks of the United States are the largest and most syndicated in the world as of August 2013. Approximately 114,200,000 American households own at least one television set due to a recent surge in the number and popularity of critically acclaimed television series. Many critics have said that American television is currently enjoying a golden age. Science and technology. This section does not cite any sources. Please help improve this section by adding citations to reliable sources. Unsourced material may be challenged and removed. July 2012. Learn how and when to remove this template message. Further information. Science and technology in the United States. The Washington Post on Monday, July 21, 1969, stating, "The Eagle has landed. Two men walk on the moon." There is a regard for scientific advancement and technological innovation in American culture, resulting in the flow of many modern innovations. The great American inventors include Robert Fulton the steamboat, Samuel Morse the telegraph, Eli Whitney the cotton gin, interchangeable parts, Cyrus McCormick the reaper, and Thomas Edison with more than 1,000 inventions credited to his name. Most of the new technological innovations over the 20th and 21st centuries were either first invented in the United States, first widely adopted by Americans, or both. Examples include the light bulb, the airplane, the transistor, the atomic bomb, nuclear power, the personal computer, the iPod, video games, online shopping, and the development of the Internet. This propensity for application of scientific ideas continued throughout the 20th century with innovations that held strong international benefits. The 20th century saw the arrival of the space age, the information age, and a renaissance in the health sciences. This culminated in cultural milestones such as the Apollo moon landings, the creation of the personal computer, and the sequencing effort called the Human Genome Project. Throughout its history, American culture has made significant gains through the open immigration of accomplished scientists. Accomplished scientists include Scottish-American scientist Alexander Graham Bell, who developed and patented the telephone and other devices, German scientist Charles Steinmetz, who developed new alternating current electrical systems in 1889, Russian scientist Vladimir Zvorykin, who invented the motion camera in 1919, Serb scientist Nikola Tesla, who patented a brushless electrical induction motor based on rotating magnetic fields in 1888. With the rise of the Nazi Party in Germany, a large number of Jewish scientists fled Germany and immigrated to the country, including theoretical physicist Albert Einstein in 1933. In the years during and following World War II, several innovative scientists immigrated to the U.S. from Europe, such as Enrico Fermi, who came from Italy in 1938 and led the work that produced the world's first self-sustaining nuclear chain reaction. Post-war Europe saw many of its scientists, such as rocket scientist Wernher von Braun, recruited by the United States as part of Operation Paperclip. Education. Main articles: Education in the United States and Educational Attainment in the United States. Higher education in the U.S. by race. As of 2003, education in the United States is and has historically been provided mainly by government control and funding come from three levels: federal, state, and local. School attendance is mandatory and nearly universal at the elementary and high school levels, often known outside the United States as the primary and secondary levels. Students have the options of having their education held in public schools, private schools, or home school. In most public and private schools, education is divided into three levels: elementary school, junior high school also often called middle school, and high school. In almost all schools at these levels, children are divided by age groups into grades. Post-secondary education, better known as college in the United States, is generally governed separately from the elementary and high school system. In the year 2000, there were 766 colonial Spanish missions in the United States. These were primarily used to convert the Native Americans to Roman Catholicism among developed countries. The U.S. is one of the most religious in terms of its demographics. According to a 2002 study by the Pew Global Attitudes Project, the U.S. was the only developed nation in the survey where a majority of citizens reported that religion played a very important role in their lives, an opinion similar to that found in Latin America today. Governments at the national, state, and local levels are a secular institution, with what is often called the separation of church and state. Although participation in organized religion has been diminishing, the public life and popular culture of the United States incorporates many Christian ideals specifically about redemption, salvation, conscience, and morality. Examples are popular culture obsessions with confession and forgiveness, which extends from reality television to 12-step meetings. Americans expect public figures to confess and have public penitence for any sins, or moral wrongdoings they may have caused, according to Salon. Examples of inadequate public penitence may include the scandals and fallout regarding Tiger Woods, Alex Rodriguez, Mel Gibson, Larry Craig, and Lance Armstrong. Brick Presbyterian Church in suburban East Orange, New Jersey. Several of the original 13 colonies were established by English settlers who wished to practice their own religion without discrimination or persecution. Pennsylvania was established by Quakers, Maryland by Roman Catholics, and the Massachusetts Bay Colony by Puritans. Separatist Congregationalists. Pilgrim Fathers founded Plymouth Colony in 1620. They were convinced that the democratic form of government was the will of God. They and the other Protestant groups applied the representative democratic organization of their congregations also to the administration of their communities in worldly matters. Rhode Island, Connecticut, and Pennsylvania added religious freedom to their democratic constitutions, becoming safe havens for persecuted religious minorities. The first Bible printed in a European language in the colonies was by German immigrant Christopher Sauer. 9 of the 13 colonies had official public religions by the time of the Philadelphia Convention of 1787. The United States became one of the first countries in the world to codify freedom of religion into law, although this originally applied only to the federal government, and not to state governments or their political subdivisions. Modeling the provisions concerning religion within the Virginia Statute for Religious Freedom, the framers of the United States Constitution rejected any religious test for office, and the First Amendment specifically denied the central government any power to enact any law respecting either an establishment of religion, or prohibiting its free exercise. In following decades, the animating spirit behind the Constitution's Establishment Clause led to the disestablishment of the official religions within the member states. The framers were mainly influenced by secular, Enlightenment ideals, but they also considered the pragmatic concerns of minority religious groups who did not want to be under the power or influence of a state religion that did not represent them. Thomas Jefferson, author of the Declaration of Independence, said, "The priest has been hostile to liberty. He is always in alliance with the despot." Statistics. The following information is an estimation, as actual statistics constantly vary according to the Pew Research Center's Religious Landscape Survey. The following is the percentage of followers of different religions in the United States: Christian, 706%; Evangelical Protestant, 254%; Mainline Protestant, 147%; Historically Black Protestant, 65%; Roman Catholic, 208%; Mormon, 16%; Other Christian, 17%; Non-Christian Faiths, 59%. Jewish, 19%; Muslim, 09%; Buddhist, 07%; Hindu, 07%; Other World Religions, 03%; Unaffiliated, 228%; Atheist, 31%; Agnostic, 40%; Nothing in Particular, 158%; Religion Not Important, 88% Religion Important, 69% Other, 15% Don't Know, 06% Folklore. This section needs expansion. You can help by adding to it. October 2012 main article: Folklore of the United States. Fireworks light up the sky over the Washington Monument. Americans traditionally shoot fireworks throughout the night on the 4th of July. National holidays. New York City's Times Square is the most famous location for New Year's celebrations in the United States, with the iconic ball drop. Halloween is popular in the United States. It typically involves dressing up in costumes and an emphasis on scary themes. Rockefeller Center Christmas tree. John F. Kennedy unofficially spares a turkey on November 19, 1963. The practice of pardoning turkeys in this manner became a permanent tradition in 1989. The United States observes holidays derived from events in American history, Christian traditions, and national patriarchs. Thanksgiving is the principal traditionally American holiday. It evolved from the English pilgrims' custom of giving thanks for one's welfare. Thanksgiving is generally celebrated as a family reunion with a large afternoon feast. Christmas Day, celebrating the birth of Jesus Christ, is widely celebrated and a federal holiday, though a fair amount of its current cultural importance is due to secular reasons. European colonization has led to some other Christian holidays such as Easter and St. Patrick's Day to be observed, though with varying degrees of religious fidelity. Independence Day, also known as the 4th of July, celebrates the anniversary of the country's declaration of independence from Great Britain. It is generally observed by parades throughout the day, and the shooting of fireworks at night. Halloween is thought to have evolved from the ancient Celtic, Gaelic festival of Samhain, which was introduced in the American colonies by Irish settlers. It has become a holiday that is celebrated by children and teens who traditionally dress up in costumes and go door-to-door trick-or-treating for candy. It also brings about an emphasis on eerie and frightening urban legends and movies. Additionally, Mardi Gras, which evolved from the Catholic tradition of carnival, is observed in New Orleans, St. Louis, Mobile, Alabama, and numerous other towns. Federally recognized holidays are as follows. Date official name remarks: January 1, New Year's Day celebrates beginning of the Gregorian calendar year. Festivities include counting down to midnight, 12 o'clock. Season, third Monday in January. Birthday of Martin Luther King Jr., or Martin Luther King Jr. Day, honors Martin Luther King Jr., civil rights leader, who was actually born on January 15, 1929. Combined with other holidays in several states, 1st January 20, following a presidential election. Inauguration Day, observed only by federal government employees in Washington, D.C., and the border counties of Maryland and Virginia to relieve traffic congestion that occurs with this major event. Swearing in of President of the United States and Vice President of the United States, celebrated every fourth year. Note, takes place on January 21 if the 20th is a Sunday, although the President is still privately inaugurated on the 20th if Inauguration Day falls on a Saturday or a Sunday. The preceding Friday or following Monday is not a federal holiday. Third Monday in February, Washington's birthday. Washington's birthday was first declared a federal holiday by an 1879 Act of Congress. The Uniform Holidays Act, 1968, shifted the date of the commemoration of Washington's birthday from February 22 to the third Monday in February. Many people now refer to this holiday as President's Day and consider it a day honoring all American presidents. However, neither the Uniform Holidays Act nor any subsequent law changed the name of the holiday from Washington's birthday to President's Day. Last Monday in May, Memorial Day honors the nation's war dead from the Civil War onwards, marks the unofficial beginning of the summer season. Traditionally May 30, shifted by the Uniform Holidays Act 1968. July 4, Independence Day, celebrates Declaration of Independence, also called the 4th of July. 1st Monday in September, Labor Day, celebrates the achievements of workers and the labor movement, marks the unofficial end of the summer season. Second Monday in October, Columbus Day, honors Christopher Columbus, traditional discoverer of the Americas. In some areas it is also a celebration of Italian culture and heritage. Traditionally October 12, celebrated as American Indian Heritage Day and Fraternal Day in Alabama, celebrated as Native American Day in South Dakota. In Hawaii, it is celebrated as Discoverer's Day, though is not an official state holiday. November 11, Veterans Day, honors all veterans of the United States Armed Forces. A traditional observation is a moment of silence at 11 o'clock. Fashion and dress. Main article: fashion in the United States. A pair of blue jeans. Fashion in the United States is eclectic and predominantly informal, while Americans' diverse cultural roots are reflected in their clothing, particularly those of recent immigrants. Cowboy hats and boots and leather motorcycle jackets are emblematic of specifically American styles. Blue jeans were popularized as work clothes in the 1850s by merchant Levi Strauss, a German Jewish immigrant in San Francisco, and adopted by many American teenagers. A century later, they are worn in every state by people of all ages and social classes, along with mass-marketed informal wear in general. Blue jeans are arguably one of U.S. culture's primary contributions to global fashion, though informal dress is more common. Certain professionals, such as bankers and lawyers, traditionally dress formally for work, and some occasions, such as weddings, funerals, dances, and some parties, typically call for formal wear. Names. Main articles: American names and African American names. The United States has few laws governing given names. Traditionally, the right to name your child or yourself as you choose has been upheld by court rulings and is rooted in the Due Process Clause of the 14th Amendment of the United States Constitution and the Free Speech Clause of the First Amendment. A few restrictions do exist. Restrictions vary by state, but most are for the sake of practicality. For example, limiting the number of characters due to limitations in record-keeping software. This freedom, along with the cultural diversity in the United States, has given rise to a wide variety of names and naming trends. Creativity has also long been a part of American naming traditions and names have been used to express personality, cultural identity, and values. Naming trends vary by race, geographic area, and socioeconomic status. African Americans, for instance, have developed a very distinct naming culture. Both religious names and those inspired by popular culture are common. Sports main article, sports in the United States since 1820, American schools focused on gymnastics, hygiene training, and care and development of the human body in the 1800s. Colleges were encouraged to focus on intramural sports, particularly track, field, and, in the late 1800s, American football physical education was incorporated into primary school curriculums. In the 20th century, a typical baseball diamond is seen from the stadium. Baseball is the oldest of the major American team sports. Professional baseball dates from 1869 and had no close rivals in popularity until the 1960s. Though baseball is no longer the most popular sport, it is still referred to as the national sport. Also, unlike the professional levels of the other popular spectator sports in the U.S., Major League Baseball teams play almost every day. The Major League Baseball regular season consists of each of the 30 teams playing 162 games from April to September. The season ends with the postseason and World Series in October. The opening of college football season is a major part of American pastime. Massive marching bands, cheerleaders, and color guard are common at American football games. American football, known in the United States as simply football, now attracts more television viewers than any other sport and is considered to be the most popular sport in the United States. The 32-team National Football League NFL is the most popular professional American football league. The National Football League differs from the other three major pro sports leagues in that each of its 32 teams plays one game a week over 17 weeks, for a total of 16 games with one bye week for each team. The NFL season lasts from September to December, ending with the playoffs and Super Bowl in January and February. Its championship game, the Super Bowl, has often been the highest-rated television show, and it has an audience of over 100 million viewers annually. College football also attracts audiences of millions. Some communities, particularly in rural areas, place great emphasis on their local high school football team. American football games usually include cheerleaders and marching bands, which aim to raise school spirit and entertain the crowd at halftime. Basketball is another major sport, represented professionally by the National Basketball Association. It was invented in Springfield, Massachusetts in 1891, by Canadian-born physical education teacher James Naismith. College basketball is also popular, due in large part to the NCAA Men's Division I basketball tournament in March. Also known as March Madness, ice hockey is the fourth leading professional team sport, always a mainstay of Great Lakes and New England area culture. The sport gained tenuous footholds in regions like the American South since the early 1990s, as the National Hockey League pursued a policy of expansion. Lacrosse is a team sport of American and Canadian Native American origin and is the fastest growing sport in the United States. Lacrosse is most popular in the East Coast area. NLL and MLL are the National Box and Outdoor Lacrosse Leagues, respectively, and have increased their following in recent years. Also, many of the top Division I college lacrosse teams draw upwards of 7,000-10,000 for a game, especially in the Mid-Atlantic and New England areas. The sport called football in many countries is typically called soccer in the United States. A 20-team professional league, Major League Soccer, plays from March to October, but its television audience and overall popularity lag behind other American professional sports. However, soccer is very popular as a participation sport, particularly among youths, and the U.S. national soccer teams are competitive internationally. NASCAR is the most watched auto racing series in the United States. Boxing and horse racing were once the most watched individual sports, but they have been eclipsed by golf and auto racing, particularly NASCAR. Other popular sports are tennis, softball, rodeo, swimming, water polo, fencing, shooting sports, hunting, volleyball, skiing, snowboarding, skateboarding, cycling, MMA, roller derby, wrestling, weightlifting, and rugby. Relative to other parts of the world, the United States is unusually competitive in women's sports, a fact usually attributed to the Title IX anti-discrimination law, which requires most American colleges to give equal funding to men's and women's sports. Despite that, however, women's sports are not nearly as popular among spectators as men's sports. The United States enjoys a great deal of success both in the Summer Olympics and Winter Olympics, constantly being ranked in the top rankings. Sports and community culture. Homecoming is an annual tradition of the United States people, towns, high schools, and Colleges come together, usually in late September or early October, to welcome back former residents and alumni. It is built around a central event, such as a banquet, a parade, and most often, a game of American football, or, on occasion, basketball, wrestling, or ice hockey when celebrated by schools. The activities vary, however. They usually consist of a football game, played on the school's home football field, activities for students and alumni, a parade featuring the school's marching band and sports teams, and the coronation of a homecoming queen. American high schools commonly field football, basketball, baseball, softball, volleyball, soccer, golf, swimming, track and field, and cross-country teams as well. Cuisine. Main article, cuisine of the United States. The cuisine of the United States is extremely diverse, owing to the vastness of the continent, the relatively large population, one-third of a billion people, and the number of native and immigrant influences. Mainstream American culinary arts are similar to those in other Western countries. Wheat and corn are the primary cereal grains. Traditional American cuisine uses ingredients such as turkey, white-tailed deer venison, potatoes, sweet potatoes, corn, squash, and maple syrup. Indigenous foods employed by American Indians and early European settlers. The types of food served at home vary greatly and depend upon the region of the country and the family's own cultural heritage. Recent immigrants tend to eat food similar to that of their country of origin, and Americanized versions of these cultural foods, such as American Chinese cuisine, Tex-Mex Mexican American cuisine, or Italian American cuisine, often eventually appear. An example is Vietnamese cuisine, Korean cuisine, and Thai cuisine. German cuisine has a profound impact on American cuisine, especially Midwestern cuisine. Potatoes, noodles, roasts, stews, cakes, and other pastries are the most iconic ingredients in both cuisines. Dishes such as the hamburger, pot roast, baked ham, and hot dogs are examples of American dishes derived from German cuisine. Different regions of the United States have their own cuisine and styles of cooking. The state of Louisiana, for example, is known for its Cajun and Creole cooking. Cajun and Creole cooking are influenced by French, Acadian, and Haitian cooking, although the dishes themselves are original and unique. Examples include crawfish etouffee, red beans and rice, seafood or chicken gumbo, jumbo Jambalaya, and Boudin. Italian, German, Hungarian, and Chinese influences, traditional Native American, Caribbean, Mexican, and Greek dishes have also diffused into the general American repertoire. It is not uncommon for a middle-class family from Middle America to eat, for example, restaurant pizza, homemade pizza, enchiladas con carne, chicken paprikas, beef stroganoff, and bratwurst with sauerkraut for dinner. Throughout a single week, soul food, developed by African slaves, is popular around the South and among many African Americans elsewhere. Syncretic cuisines such as Louisiana Creole, Cajun, Pennsylvania Dutch, and Tex-Mex are regionally important. Iconic American dishes such as apple pie, fried chicken, pizza, hamburgers, and hot dogs derive from the recipes of various immigrants and domestic innovations. French fries, Mexican dishes such as burritos and tacos, and pasta dishes freely adapted from Italian sources are consumed. Americans generally prefer coffee to tea, and more than half the adult population drinks at least one cup a day. Marketing by U.S. industries is largely responsible for making orange juice and milk now often fat-reduced ubiquitous breakfast beverages. During the 1980s and 1990s, Americans' caloric intake rose 24%. Frequent dining at fast food outlets is associated with what health officials call the American obesity epidemic. Highly sweetened soft drinks are popular. Sugared beverages account for 9% of the average American's daily caloric intake. Hamburgers, fries, and donuts are considered American foods. Some representative American foods: traditional Thanksgiving dinner with turkey, dressing, sweet potatoes, and cranberry sauce. A cream-based New England chowder, traditionally made with clams and potatoes. A Caesar salad containing croutons, Parmesan cheese, lemon juice, olive oil, Worcestershire and pepper. Creole jambalaya with shrimp, ham, tomato, and andouille. Sausage. Chicken fried steak, alternatively known as country fried steak. California club pizza with avocados and tomatoes. A submarine sandwich, which includes a variety of Italian luncheon meats. American style breakfast with pancakes, maple syrup, sausage links, bacon strips, and fried eggs. A hot dog. Sausage topped with beef chili, white onions, and mustard. A barbecue pulled pork sandwich with coleslaw as the side dish. A meatloaf with a tomato sauce. sauce topping an apple cobbler dessert. Family structure. Further information. Family structure in the United States. American family structure has no particular household arrangement being prevalent enough to be identified as the average. Family arrangements in the United States reflect the nature of contemporary American society, as they always have, although the nuclear family concept, two married adults with biological children, holds a special place in the mindset of Americans. It is single parent families, childless couples, and fused families which now constitute the majority of families. A person may grow up in a single-parent family, go on to marry and live in childless couple arrangement, then get divorced, live as a single for a couple of years, remarry, have children and live in a nuclear family arrangement. The nuclear family is the idealized version of what most people think when they think of family. The old definition of what a family is, the nuclear family, no longer seems adequate to cover the wide diversity of household arrangements we see today. According to many social scientists, Edwards 1991, Stacey 1996, thus has arisen the term postmodern family, which is meant to describe the great variability in family forms, including single-parent families and child-free couples. Brian K. Williams, Stacey C. Sawyer, Carl M. Wahlstrom, Marriages, Families.